Now, ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome Rescue.
For he whose walk is blameless may live on your holy hill, and he whose work is righteous may live on your holy hill. Lord, who may dwell in your on your holy hill, who may live on your holy hill, who may live on your holy hill.
The world was spinning, and passing me by. I was fooled by the desires of my mind. It went running out of control, ignoring all the things that the book told me. Yeah. Now I'm here to testify that you never give up on me. I'm so excited, 'cause I've been saved by the love of God.
Reunited,
why would I go? Why would I fall? From all of my chains, I've been set free. Oh, and the power of his love has rescued me. And now I'm here to shout it out, you never give up on me. I'm so excited, 'cause I've been saved by the love of God.
Reunited,
why would I go, why would I go?
So excited,
where could I go? Ain't it amazing how he turned your life around? There's just no doubt about it. I was lost, but now I'm found.
So excited,
'cause I've been saved by the love of God.
My heart so long ago, he
had said. Now he calls for you, for you. Yes, he died for me and you, for you.
So what in this world are you living for? Is it for your money or fame or something more? When it's said and done, when life is through, he wants those who know.
He died for me and you, for you.
He paid such a price, he gave up his life. I promise this choice you won't regret.
For better or worse,
no one can reverse the way that he feels.
He is Christ, he could have saved himself. And yet still he was nailed to that tree. Is offered to you,
offered to you.
And I promise you, yes, I promise you, yes, I promise he loves you. Yes, he died for me and you,
We are so excited to be here tonight. We're so grateful that you have come. This is a really cool time for us to be able to reunite with the guys that we have sung with for the last 7.5 years. I want to take a minute. My name is Jason, and I've been married for going on 9 years. I've been in this group for 7.5, and I've got a little 15-month-year-old daughter named Macy. So that's what's going on with me. On my far left, every group has its beginning, and on my far left is the guy that started this group, arranges 100% of the music that we sing. In this group, he sings everything from baritone to high tenor, and also does what we call vocal percussion. Please help me welcome my good friend, Jason Overstreet. So I'm Jason, I just introduced Jason, and on my far right is yet another Jason. He's been with this group for about 4.5 years. In that amount of time, I have come to know him as one of the most generous people I've ever come into contact with. He's my great fishing buddy. He loves Harley-Davidson motorcycles. In this group, he sings everything from baritone to high trumpet at times. Please help me welcome my other good friend, Jason Pierce. And then laying the foundation of what we do is our newest member. He's been with us for about 1.5 years. He comes from Branson, Missouri, where he was in a 50s rock and roll show called 50s at the Hop. He sings bass for us, thankfully. And just a little tidbit about him, he happens to be known as the lowest bass in the world. He's recorded the lowest note ever recorded by a human. Please help me welcome Rescue's newest member, Tim Storms.
See, I once I was so lost, but now I am found. Was blind.
Was grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. Thou precious that grace of me, the when we've been there 10,000 years, bright shining as the sun, we've no distance to see us in God's praise than when we first began.
Sometimes I'm lazy and drag my feet. My walk becomes a crawl. The motivation I have takes a hike. Standards begin to fall. I'm a child of the king that has a nice ring. I should be changing lives, you see. I'm feeling lazy and sitting around. Well, it's easier to me.
How did Daniel face the lions? How did Moses part the sea? How did Noah build that ark? What's so wrong with me? If it's faithful, I'm mistaken. Could you show me some right now? If I need to catch a glimpse of you, could you show me yourself now?
6 a.m. and then I'm hitting snooze, trying to face another day. Two paths to choose, mine or his. Will I follow or will I stray? I wanna make a difference to invest in eternity. Without you, I'm inadequate, powerless to succeed.
How did Daniel face the lions? How did Moses part the sea? How did Noah build that ark? And what's wrong with me? If it's faithful, I'm missing. Could you show me some right now? If I need to catch a glimpse of you,
could you show me yourself now? I'm calling out for your wisdom, for the moving of your hand,
asking you for your guidance and the courage to take a step. That's how Daniel faced the lions and Moses split that sea. That's how I'll make a difference by the Spirit of God in me. What I'm missing, could you show me some right now? If I need to catch a glimpse of you,
could you show me yourself now?
I'm calling out for your wisdom,
for the moving of your hand,
asking you for your guidance and the courage to take a step.
How did
Daniel,
how did Daniel,
Moses,
how did Moses
know why he built that ark, and what is so wrong with me? If I need to catch a glimpse of you,
could you show me yourself?
How can I make a difference?
Well, now please welcome former Rescue members Josh McKinney and Chad Krober.
Fun. Chad Krober was our original first tenor for the first 3 to 4 years of Rescue. We met back in college and sang together back in choir and just have been good friends for many, many years. But one thing I remember about Chad, in the years that he was with Rescue, he would always show up to Rescue rehearsal with a Diet Coke in hand. And what's kind of interesting about that is last week, as we started rehearsals for tonight, we hadn't sung together and it's been 3 years or so at least, he showed up Diet Coke in hand. Nothing's changed. What's even more interesting is the high tenor that took his spot also drinks Diet Coke, so something about high tenors. It's just good to see Chad. We're just honored to have all the reunion guys here, and it's just so fun to sing with Chad again. Would you let everybody know what you're up to these days?
Well, the last 4 years, I'm still living in the area. I am working for a computer company in Tiger doing project management and installation coordination. I'm working on a master's degree at George Fox University, and I'm still married to my wonderful wife, Megan, and thank you, appreciate that. I agree too. And it is just a pleasure to be with you here this evening. It's an honor that the guys called us up who have been in past Rescue situations to join you here this evening. It's wonderful to be with you.
Chad is the one who wrote and arranged the song Rescue, which is a song that we continue to sing in every single Rescue concert to this day. It's a song that has meant a ton to us over the years, and we've asked him to share where that song came from.
Back in 1994, I went to the Christian Artist Seminar in Estes Park, Colorado, and heard a concert by Andre Crouch. And Andre Crouch, if you don't know it, has been incredibly influential in the contemporary Christian music scene and in music that is sung in churches today over the last 30, 35 years. And really only one thing that he said that entire evening stuck with me. What he said was, if you want to write songs and music that lasts, you go to God's Word, because God's Word has lasted, and it's lasted for eternity, and it will last for eternity. So I went to Psalms and began to read the Psalms, and I came to Psalm 35. Psalm 35, King David is crying out to his heavenly Father. It is a cry for rescue from his enemies, and that is where the song Rescue came from.
But one of the joys for me of singing this group was that for 5.5 years or thereabouts, I got to sing with my little brother. And about a year and a half ago, my little brother made the decision to step off stage, and we started traveling a lot more, and he had a second child on the way, and he made a decision that we all respected, to find a little more stability at home. And I just want to take a little time and talk with Josh and see what he's been up to. Josh, what have you been doing since you left Rescue?
Well, like you said, had a second boy, got two boys now. Bryce is the oldest, 3 and a half, and Jaden is the youngest. He's 11 months and saying dad now right now. And I'm working at Gresham Outlook right now, and actually just got a new job at a great company called stateoforegon.com.
And when the guys in Rescue cannot figure out how in the world to put anything on a website or do anything computer related, who do we call?
I try to do it. I try.
My little brother. Thanks, Josh. It's good to have Josh back. One of my favorite songs to sing while Josh was a part of Rescue was this song, Obey Him.
How can I show him love? I obey him. How can I show the one from above my love? Obey him. And how can I show him love? I obey him. How can I show the one from above my love? Obey him.
I will obey.
For he did not write these words for me just to read. He calls me to obey. So by faith I trust in you as I do what you say. Not by my might, but yours. But how can I show him love? I obey him.
I will obey him.
And how can I show the one from above my love? Obey him. How can I show him love? I obey him.
How can I show?
How can I show the one from above my love? Obey him. Now my hope is set on you. My gaze is fixed and straight. I'm looking up to you. Then you take my hand and say, my son, walk this way. How can I show him love? I obey him. And how can I show the one from above my love? Obey him. And how can I show him love? I obey him. How can I show the one from above my love? Obey him.
I will obey him.
How can I show him love? Yeah. Obey him. Whoa, how can I show the one from above my love? Obey him. Whoa, how can I show love? Can I show him love? Obey him. How can I show the one from above my love? Obey him. How can I show him love?
Psalm 139 says, where can I go from your spirit? Where can I flee from your presence? If I ascend to the heavens, you are there. If I make my bed in the depths, you are there. If I rise on the wings of the dawn, if I settle across from the sea, even there your hand shall lead me. Your right hand will hold me fast.
Thank you. spirit, where shall I flee?
For those of you who don't know this guy, his name is Matt Lusk. He is the original bass from Rescue. 7 years ago, he started in this group as the bass, and he is actually the one that we affectionately call Matty. So if you hear us talking about Matty, this is him. And so in the last 6 years, Matty, what have you been doing?
Well, for most of that time, I was a youth pastor down in Southern California, and now I run a camp for my church in the Southern Sierra Nevada Mountains, kind of by Bakersfield, for those of you who know where that's at. I'm married now. Of course, and I have four beautiful babies. Not all at once, but
if you have heard our Christmas album, you heard a song called Mary Did You Know? And the lead voice on that was actually Matt Lusk. He flew up to be a soloist on that song. Yeah. So we're going to share that with you now. This is Mary Did You Know?
Give me a second.
One thing that you've probably noticed as you look up here is that we don't dance. That's wise on our part. But you know, we've seen a lot of groups that do, and we've seen a lot of groups that do a lot of high energy choreography. And we thought, we can do that. If we focus all of our attention and energy into one song, that is. And this is that song. Let me get out of the way. Guys are preparing. This is probably our most difficult piece. This is just preparation. Hey, before we go any further, if I could, I'd like to explain some of the noises that you guys hear tonight. I see some confused looks. And see, sometimes when you sing bass like I do, you get stuck on the bahs and the dooms. Ask Josh, he knows. And see, not this next song. I'm singing lead, and so will Josh, as you'll see. This is important, too. As we go into the song, I need everybody here to realize that under no circumstances would we ever lip sync.
Don't worry. be happy.
Look at me, I'm happy.
Don't worry. Be happy.
Look at me, I'm happy.
Litigate, litigate, don't worry. Be happy.
Look at me, I'm happy.
Don't worry, be happy.
Now there is this song I wrote.
I hope you learned it note for note like good little children. Don't worry. Be happy. Listen to what I say. In your life, expect some trouble.
When you worry, expect trouble. Don't worry. Be happy.
Clap louder on that song than all the songs that we actually sang. That's insulting.
In this ministry, we believe very, very strongly in the power of prayer. And it has been a joy for me to sit back and watch as God has developed a prayer team for this ministry. Probably started 3 or 4 years ago and is now running 200 plus. And these people that faithfully pray each week for us get an update how specifically to pray, and we constantly are hearing back from them on how they are praying for us and just words of encouragement. They have been incredible in this ministry. And kind of leading that, there's kind of three main ladies that I'd like to thank right now. First of all, someone that was praying for us long before the prayer team got together, someone would show up at all of our concerts and I'd see her just praying during the concerts. She's here tonight. Can't find her. her name is Susan Ward, and she's here tonight with two of girls that are right under her that also helped us, named Kelly Jo and Jackie. Would you guys just give them a round of applause for us?
This in his word, so be imitators of our God as children dearly loved. You were once in darkness, now you're light to him. So set your mind on things above. Oh, forgetting what's behind. And the time when my soul was dead, pressing forward towards the goal.
Well, as you could see from the video, and what I am finding out more and more each day is Tim is a hilarious man. And, you know, he just makes a lot of funny noises. That comes with being able to sing off the bottom of the piano. And lately, as we've been warming up, Tim has been making some noises that have kind of developed into something. And the best way to describe this to you would be two aliens having a conversation.
Oh, I got it. Get him out of my pocket, just a second.
Tim's been with us for about a year and a half, and it's just been an amazing time because there are times that the three of us Jasons who can't sing low at all, we just kind of want to listen to him sing. We'll be in the middle of a song and we kind of forget that we're supposed to be singing a part. So we just want to listen to him sing some parts, but we're going to have him sing a bass solo for you tonight. Before he does, I just want to say that the thing that impresses me most about Tim, he has an incredible gift from the Lord, an amazing talent that nobody else has. And he could be doing many, many different things with that voice in different places. And he has chosen to take that voice and serve the Lord with it. And that's impressive to me.
Gotta walk
that lonesome road I've got to hold my Savior's hand. I've got to walk.
Make us broken bread and poured out wine just to feed the needs of them. If we bow on bended knee before the Lord, why do they gather at the gates when they see the Father's face and look as family as the leaders take their place? Stand and sing the praise of one. Will be revealed by those who speak and sing his praise. Who will rise
and let the Father fill his words? Who will rise?
Who will rise
to see the truth of him be heard? And who will rise? Who will rise and see the to be fed, knowing to you the Lord has said, will you rise?
And I will rise,
rise. I will rise to the occasion.
To the occasion.
I will rise
from my knees and trust the Lord. I will
sin to show a life of sin can be redeemed by him. The cry of our hearts is their soul to win.
And I will rise,
I will rise to the occasion,
to the occasion.
I will
rise from my knees and trust the Lord. I will
rise and run the race he showed us. the Lord, I will rise. I will rise and magnify the Lord.
I will rise, I will rise from my Lord. I will rise from bad will in me.
Broken bread and poured out wine just to feed the needs of them. If we only bow our knees before the Lord.
Going on 9 years ago, when I got married, I made some vows to my wife. Vows that said that she was the only woman for me. Vows that said, in sickness or in health, I'll stay by her side. I've seen an increasing trend in America, all over the world really, that those vows don't mean as much as they used to, that people enter into marriage a lot more lightly than they used to. Thus, really saying, I really didn't mean it when I said those things. I knew that maybe it wasn't gonna work out. And I feel like, as I view people today who claim to be Christians, I feel like I see the same trend. In America, almost everybody is very quick to say, I'm a Christian. And they say it based on that's kind of where this country was founded. Maybe you grew up going to church. But people enter it and say it lightly. And really, to say you are a Christian, there is nothing light about it. To say you are a Christian is to claim something that is heavy, that is very deep, that has a lot of meaning. Because to say that I'm a Christian means that I'm putting my faith and my trust in Jesus. See, if when I entered my marriage and gave the vows to my wife, and then a couple weeks later, you viewed my marriage and saw me doing whatever I wanted, not paying any attention to my wife, running around with whoever I wanted, it would be hard for you to believe that I'm married. And yet we say that we are a Christian and we live however we want. And God is calling for something more from us. See, because I'm a Christian, first of all, I gotta tell you, I didn't earn it. I'm a sinner. I have fallen short of a perfect God. There's nothing that I can do to earn it. But don't mistake that for Christian, to become a Christian is easy. It came at a tremendous cost, and that cost was the Son of God. And He loves you so much, the Creator of this world loves you so much, that He came to this earth 2,000 years ago, specifically for the purpose of knowing you can't earn your way to God. He wanted to provide a way for you. And so today, I live for God and seek to find out what He has for me in His Word, not to earn His favor, but because He has granted me His favor through His Son, Jesus. I hope that's sinking in. I know there's some people here tonight that hasn't quite clicked yet. Wherever you are with that, if you know Jesus, you know your heart is His, but you realize, you know what, I'm here tonight and I haven't been living for Him. There's some things in the way. There's some things where I've gotten off track and my focus is gone, but I know I'm His. Maybe you'll use tonight as a recommitment to Him. But if you have not yet acknowledged, first of all, that He exists and you're in need of Him and what He did for you on a cross, maybe tonight as we sing this next song, this will be the first time that you've even acknowledged Him. He can hear your thoughts. He knows you better than you know yourself. And as we sing, maybe this will be the first time right where you sit that you've ever done business with God.
A little child kneels before God's throne. Boom, boom, boom. To his left is a man bound in chains. Boom, 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 boom. And to his right now the soul shall light. Boom, boom, boom. Neither one did God turn away. Boom, boom,
boom, boom. For each one had come to this place. Boom, boom, boom. To be near the Holy One. Set free by grace, by the calling of the Son, come as you are. Oh, 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 oh. Right where you are. Oh, oh, oh.
Little child is welcome, same as the sinful, but each must take a stand to be heirs of God's own kingdom. Reach out and take a stand.
There's never been a better time to come to Him. There's never been a better place than here.
Come as you are. Oh, oh, oh. Right where you are. Oh, oh.
He's been calling. He's been waiting, and He's been watching, anticipating. There's no reason to keep on delaying.
So come just as you are, right now, just as you are. So come as you
are means you don't clean yourself up to present yourself to God. That's backwards. It means you bring yourself to God and say, this is me. You do the job in my heart that I cannot do on my own.
He's been calling. He's been waiting. He's been watching. Anticipating, there's no reason to keep on delaying.
So come just as you are, right now, just as you are. So come as you are.
So why respond to Him? Why not just take it easy and see what happens at the end of your life? I want to challenge you tonight. Respond to Him because He is the truth. The Bible says that Jesus is the way and the truth and the life. And we get one chance, our life today, we get one chance to respond to Him and to accept Him and to give our lives to Him. And as long as we still have a breath, as long as our heart's beating, that's because God's given us more grace to listen to Him and to follow Him. Right now, I'm going to pray. Prayer is not a weird word. It's not a something to be afraid of. Prayer just simply means I'm going to talk to God. And he has opened up that channel for me to do that and for you to do that. It's just simply communication, and he hears us. And if you're sitting here tonight and you want to speak with him, maybe for the first time, and something that I say resonates with you, feel free to pray along with me in the quietness where you sit. Please bow your heads. Lord, all of this tonight, the cameras, the lights, the stuff that we don't normally have, Lord, and Lord, it's all, it's cool, but it's meaningless, Lord. What we desire so strongly, Lord, is for you to connect with some people here tonight, Lord, including us, that you would once again remind us, Lord, of our need for you. Remind us, Lord, what this life is all about. It's wrapped up, Lord, in a relationship with you, that you have provided a way to happen, God. And it's found on a cross, Lord. It's there where my sins were forgiven, Lord, because that's where I placed my faith and trust. Lord, if you're calling someone here tonight, God, to realize that in their heart, that, God, they're a sinner. They don't measure up. But yours is the only perfect man. Jesus is the only perfect man that has ever lived. And that's why his sacrifice pays the debt for my sin. That's why we can be clean before God. Lord, continue to reveal that like you revealed it to so many in this room. Continue to reveal that to the people that you have created, God, and we'll give you all the praise and glory for that. In your name, amen. How do I know one of the ways that God loves me? It's because of what he did for me on a cross. 2,000 years ago, when this factual event happened, when Jesus died on a cross, he was not only thinking of the people then, but he was thinking of everybody here in this room tonight. 2,000 years ago, Jesus was thinking of me.
Three crosses stood on a hill, and the unmistakable message of intent to kill. To those who were watching, to those who could see, the Christ was to die there on Calvary.
He had to bear all the torture
and unearthly pain.
They ridiculed and mocked him,
but he loved them just the same.
When it was all over, they realized what they'd done. They had just killed God's only son. 2,000 years ago, they put his cross in the ground.
2,000 years ago, his blood flowed down.
And though my foolish heart finds it hard to believe,
2,000 years ago, he was thinking of me. He knew it would happen, though he told them not when. God with us would perish to save us from sin. The feeling was heavy, the crowd's voices raised. When his life ended, our souls were saved. 2,000 years ago, they put his cross in the ground.
2,000 years ago, his blood flowed down.
And though my foolish heart finds it hard to believe,
2,000 years ago, oh, he was thinking of me. And now when I look at that time, I can scarcely imagine the degree of the crime. I'd like to think myself a disciple crying out loud, but I know from my thousand years ago, they put his cross in the ground.
2,000 years ago, his blood flowed down.
And though my foolish heart finds it hard to believe,
2,000 years ago, he
was thinking of me 2,000 years ago. They put his cross in the ground
2,000 years ago. His blood flowed down.
And though my foolish heart finds it hard to believe, 2,000 years ago he was thinking of me. By his hand we are healed, by his word truth revealed, by his grace yes, we can be born again. Oh, there is rest in his wing, that's why we praise. Yeah, the Lord's coming back and you know I'm gonna be with him.
Be with him while the Lord has him. I decided I do to get my name up on that golden page. Oh, but the Lord said to me, if you wanna be free, well, I'm me with all your heart today and heart, boy, can't you see?
Well, I heard of heaven above, yeah, I'd heard of heavenly love, but I never believed it'd come to me. Until that day he touched my heart, that's when I made the start. Love the Lord for who he is now, that's the very best part. Whoa.
Well, my death I used to fear, cause I wasn't sure that it was near. And I thought my soul could not be saved. But now when that trumpet sounds, my soul is roaring mad. And I know that in heaven that the devil won't be coming up.
By his hand we are healed, by his word, by his grace,
yes,
we can be born again. And oh, there is rest in his wings,
that's why we praise.
Yeah, the Lord's coming back, and you know I'm gonna be.
The Lord's coming back,
and you know I'm gonna be.
Yeah, the Lord's coming back,
and you know I'm gonna be with.
Please welcome back Chad Krober, Matt Lusk, and Josh McKinney.
Do 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 grace fall on us.
I'm quitting the blues of the world. Just singing a song, Glory, hallelujah, I just phoned the parson. Hey, boy, get ready to call. Just like Humpty Dumpty, I'm ready to fall. Because I'm sitting on top of the world. Just roll along, just roll along. I'm sitting on top of the world. Roll along, roll along. I'm quitting the blues of the world. Just singing a song,
just singing a song,
just singing a song. Glory, hallelujah, I just phoned the parson. Hey, pa, get ready to call. Just like Humpty Dumpty, I'm ready to fall. Because I'm sitting on top of the world. Just singing a song, just singing a song. I'm sitting on top of the world.
I'm all right. I'm all right, keep going, keep going.
No, I can't
choose you.
Ability to seek and know you.
Well, I believe it won't change the fact of what you did, but you leave it up to me.
Choose the right way, choose to live.
I can tell about you. I just lose my voice. Yeah, 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 yeah.
Thanks so much for coming tonight. Have a good night.
God bless you.